Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the Paton School Grade 4 celebration. We're so happy to see everyone here this morning. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Jane Lazotte, and I am the principal here at Paton School, and very, very happy to be serving the community in this role. I attended kindergarten here several years ago, and I'm overjoyed to be back with all of you. We are going to begin this morning's program listening, and feel free to sing along, to two juniors from Shrewsbury High School. They will be singing their first time live this year. We are the fortunate recipients. Deeptha Ganesh, class of 2022, and Allie Sawyer, class of 22. And I know Allie is a Paton alum. Deeptha, are you as well? Yay, so Deeptha is here representing Floral Elementary School. So please stand, I'd ask our flag holders, we don't have a flag out here, but if you'd come to the front, we will listen to Deeptha and Allie. The Star Spangled Banner, our national anthem.
So proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. O'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glow, the bombs bursting in.
Thank you, Deeptha and Allie. Though Deeptha is a Floral alum, I'm sure she will wear our gift proudly. It's a Paton Elementary School shirt to represent Shrewsbury. So Allie and Deeptha, these are for you. Thank you again. Well, I want to congratulate everyone here, our students, our families, and educators, for persevering and working together during this very demanding and difficult school year. A year that has tested our patience as well as our physical, mental, and emotional health. Despite the significant challenges with which we were confronted, each of you proved to be trusting, courageous, responsible, respectful, and hopeful as you faced numerous obstacles that made living and learning complex. As the proverbial phrase goes, when life gives you lemons, make lemonade. You made this choice with poise and grace. We are grateful for the unwavering support of parents, caretakers, teachers, families, and friends, for their love and selflessness. Please be sure, grade 4 students, to thank these special people at some point over the next 24 hours. I ask that you pause for just a moment to reflect on where you have been and what you have done since your earliest memories of life. When I graduated from Shrewsbury High School several years ago, 1983, my dad was invited to speak to my classmates and his role as justice on the Massachusetts Supreme Judicial Court at the time. He was honored to share his words of wisdom with my classmates, words that I find myself revisiting often. I'd like to share a few of those with you today. The end of your elementary school experience is an ideal time for reflection on who you have become and how that came to be. That reflection will likely lead you further, not for the first time, I am sure, to a recognition of those people who have contributed so much to your life, including your parents and caretakers, your siblings and your friends. It will also lead you, perhaps more than ever before, to appreciate the efforts of those incredible people who have served you as teachers, who have given you a part of themselves, possibly at times when you may not have wanted the help. I am confident that I speak for you and for your families in expressing gratitude to the educators at Paton School who have shared their gifts with you so that you may, in turn, have more to give others. Does this advice sound familiar? Make it a great day or not. Let's try that again. Make it a great day or not. The choice is yours, and we're reminded every morning during morning announcements that each of us has the freedom to make choices and on the significance of those choices. We have a free will, and all important aspects of the course of our life depends on how we use it. Of course, we can't accurately predict what the future will bring, but I suggest that you ought to approach life after elementary school with the confidence that the choices you make will have far more influence on the quality of your life than any other factor. Life is not just a happening beyond our control, though the COVID pandemic resulted in significant changes in our lives. We need to recognize our personal responsibility for who we have been, for who we are, and who we will be. Oftentimes, we ignore that responsibility, and instead, we comfort ourselves with the thought that we cannot help our situation. While we are affected by challenges beyond our control, sometimes deeply affected, how we deal with those challenges and respond to them is up to us. Just as we can choose to follow rules at home and at school, we can also choose to be disciplined or not, to work hard or not, to reach high or low, to be active or passive, to participate in community service, or to accept unacceptable social conditions as someone else's problem. We are free to be kind or not, to love our neighbor or not. We are free, and that at once calls for responsibility and gives us hope for the future. I think that it is important for you to recognize that if most of the choices you make are good, your life will be good too. The reins are in your hands, and while you may not totally control what your life will be, you have an awful lot to say about it. Try hard not to be afraid of what lies ahead, but say yes, yes to life, secure in the knowledge that you have had a strong start and that life progresses in small steps. Be confident and be aware of your worth, remembering that every single one of us is a teacher, whether by profession or not. You have also heard this message on several occasions during morning announcements. Nearly everything we do influences someone else and has impact that we rarely see. You can change the world for better or worse, not by any one great act, but by how you live, by the choices you make. Thank you from the bottom of my heart for being incredible friends and classmates to one another, whether remotely or in person, and for setting an extraordinary example of courage, respect, responsibility, and kindness for all of our students at Paton School. I am deeply grateful to you for your generosity. Thank you. At this time, I invite our grade four teachers up. You can come one at a time or all at once, but we'll begin with Mrs. Cormier. We have Mrs. Cormier, Ms. Delaney, Mrs. Hollier, and Mrs. Moran.
Thank you, Dr. Lazat. Congratulations to my fourth graders on an amazing, challenging year. First up, Roshan Anand. Yajas Devaguptapu. Kabri Pandrakan. Joanna Ma. Callie Mui. Charan Nagredi. Aditya Naveen. Aditya Shankar. I'm sorry, Vidya Shankar. Ananya Sharma. Dash Srivastava. Elon Sinekin. Anthoniska Suresh Kumar Pranavina. Thank you. All right, next up is the Delaney class. Congratulations to you all. We will start with Caden Appenzeller. Maya Avejaneda. Ellie Bolt. Sarah Clark. Logan Eck. Owen Girardi. Dylan Harris. Matthew Henning. Gino Leardi. Colin Lucy. Bryn Melhuish. Armin Meridian. Nadine Nishiwe. Suleiman Osmani. Adrian Quinlan. John Ripley. Alyssa Suter. Rajat Upadhyay. Lowell Watson. Coco Wiafi. Last but not least, Catherine Zane. Thank you, everyone.
Next up is the Hollier class. I'd like to start by recognizing Irina Biswas. Maura Clifford. Casey Dowling. Jana Iada. Kayla Espino. Ella Fogg. Ethan Griswold. Braden Kent. Chloe LaPlume. Cooper Lindsay. Catherine McGarry. Abigail Mwanda. Corwin Mulryan. Ben Nocher. Maddie Schwab. Caleb Roy. Maeve Shanley. Sashwat Sharanyan. Wania Wakas. Lucas Wentworth. And Ivana Wu. Congratulations, room 19.
I'm excited and proud to be able to celebrate this special class in this very memorable year. First up is Ava Augusto. Olivia Austin. Braden Ballion. Jack Benway. Ryan Boulay. Joey Sergio. Sienna DiPiazza. Chloe Lothrop. Brody Mateko. Lila McCray. Nora Peppersack. Nishta Raghu. Aaliyah Ryder. Jonah Ryder. William Toomey. Nived Vibin. Samuela Volsi. Matthew Wentworth. And Mari Wiseman. How about a big round of applause for our wonderful, outstanding fourth graders. Congratulations. At this time, I invite Ellie Bolt and Gino Liardi to the front. They will present Paton's Class of 2021 Class Legacy Project and Gift.
School's class of 2021 is very grateful to Shrewsbury High School sophomore Jack Newell, whose mom, Mrs. Newell, works on our team in her role as a special educator. Jack is working toward the rank of Eagle Scout and has chosen the Paton Nature Trail for the focus of a service project focus. We cannot be happier to contribute to this incredible effort.
Jack's goal include improving the nature trail by expanding the experience to make it more engaging and educational for students and families in the community. He will work to construct a small sign at the entrance with pictures of plants and wildlife that can be found on the trail. He will include QR codes that provide access to a series of scavenger hunts. During the summer months and early fall, Jack will highlight the trails by defining the path with logs and marking the trees. The roof on the owl house is in need of repairs, along with a couple of boards that needed to be replaced on the footbridge. Jack will fix these while also adding another small wooden walkway across a marshy area. Please be sure to check out Jack's plans on the chart board next to the dining tent. Thank you.
Well said, Ellie and Gino. Thank you. And we also have some kindness rocks that will be sprinkled throughout along the trail that our fourth graders are working on. We have some samples up here if you'd like to check them out following the ceremony. So grade four students, it is time to hand jive with Miss Phallus Barrill. Turn that way towards all your loving family members and friends. Time to hand jive. Bravo. Thank you, Miss Phallus Barrill and students. When I went to Miss Phallus Barrill maybe a month ago and said, oh no, we can't sing, what do we do at the grade four celebration? She said, let me think on that. And it took her about 12 minutes until she came back and said, I got it. We're gonna do a hand jive and we're gonna sign to a beautiful song, I got it. And I said, how are we going to teach our in-person and all remote students that? She said, I got that too. I'm going to teach another teacher, and I'm going to do a video of myself. And thank you so much. That was just wonderful and fun. And before I ask our next, actually, I'll ask our next two students to come up so they can get ready for the presentation of staff gifts. But I also want to thank Greg Marceau for being here. Greg is our go-to sound person, and that's not his title. It's a big one in the district. He has already been to the Oak Middle School field day this morning. He's at Paton. He's going off to Spring Street School. He's a very busy person and gives his time and energy very generously. We also have Liz Poplowski here from Shrewsbury Media Connection taping our celebration, so we can share that link with all of you. And we have a photographer from the Community Advocate. So thank you all for all your support. It's phenomenal. At this time, I invite Abigail, Corwin, Nora, and Nishta to the front. They're going to present some staff gifts.
Many Paton staff to thank as we conclude our elementary experience at Paton School. Without the support of all these kind, caring, and hardworking and humble people, we would not have experienced the joy and learning we did, particularly this year, without the steadfast commitment to our students, staff, and families. At this time, I would like to recognize Dr. Jane Lazotte for her compassionate leadership, and no matter what the situation, she listens with empathy and respect. Thank you for making this learning establishment welcoming. The responsibilities of a school nurse and healthcare provider have never been greater. Please join me in thanking our incredible school nurse, Mrs. Lisa Smith, for her dedication, care, and perseverance.
Our fabulous school nurse is taking care of someone inside, so we'll be sure she gets her gift.
Mrs. Lindy LaPierre, our school secretary, helps steer the Paton school ship and always in the right direction. She knows all the members of the community and constantly has a can-do attitude. Thank you for taking care of us all these years, Mrs. LaPierre.
Of serving others, one important member of the Paton community immediately comes to mind. Chef Rob Ozero makes lunchtime one of the most treasured times of the day. Thank you, Chef Rob, for creating lunches that are delicious and always leave us with wanting more. Mr. Artie Rose works behind the scenes each day to ensure that our school is clean, organized, and safe. His year-round efforts do not go unnoticed. Mr. Rose can often be found in the cafe gymatorium visiting with students at all grade levels. We appreciate his interest in our hobbies and learning. Thank you, Mr. Rose. Mrs. Wendy Moran is a kind and caring teacher who works very hard to provide meaningful and interesting learning experiences for her students. She models life learning and never gives up on Mrs. Moran. She is always willing to help out, whether that is working outside at a station for an entire field day or mentoring new teachers. We appreciate her can-do attitude. Thank you for leading by example, Mrs. Moran. Mrs. Jen Berry is a go-to member of the Paton staff. She consistently goes the extra mile for her students and staff because she wants to be sure that every student has the resources they need to be successful in and out of the classroom. We are very grateful to Mrs. Berry for her dedication.
Is an exceptional paraprofessional who supports us in many ways. She brings smiles to our faces when we need it most, never hesitates to help us with anything we need. Mrs. Shea is kind, caring, and empathetic. Thank you for your dedication to Paton School, Mrs. Shea. Words that describe Mrs. Hollier include mindful, compassionate, hardworking, student-centered, kind, and diligent. Mrs. Hollier adores her students, and it shows in all that she says about her class and does with her class. We are grateful to Mrs. Hollier for her courage and wisdom as we made our way through this most unusual year. Miss Delaney, characteristics that come to mind include caring, intuitive, flexible, forgiving, strong, and positive. Miss Delaney's smile lights up a room, and her giggles can be heard from quite a distance. We are very appreciative to Miss Delaney for leading the way with positivity, energy, and wisdom. She is an amazing teacher who leads by example. Mrs. Cormier has gone above and beyond in her role as all remote grade 4 teacher at Paton School this year, teaching students at Coolidge and Paton. Her creativity, determination, organization, and positivity have resulted in a close classroom community that includes students from both Paton School and Coolidge School. Mrs. Cormier started this challenging journey just weeks after giving birth to her youngest child, yet she never wavered. Every student in her class felt cared for, loved, and respected like one of her own. Thank you for your commitment to the education of fourth grade students across our school district, Mrs. Cormier.
Miss Graham is dependable, kind, flexible, and patient. She helps us with anything we need, no matter how much she has going on. We appreciate Miss Graham's patience and calm demeanor. Thank you for all that you do for us, Miss Graham. Mrs. Newell has really helpful strategies that we use to be more independent thinkers and learners. She never gives up on us, no matter what. Mrs. Newell understands the needs of children and does whatever she can to be better organized and get our assignments done. Thank you for supporting us, Mrs. Newell. Mrs. Phallis Burrill is a joyful, funny music teacher who always has a story to share. Her musical talents are second to none. Mrs. Phallis Burrill brings out the best in her students as she appreciates each of us for who we are. Thank you for providing us with a really great music experience during this very challenging school year.
And I have a few to add. Thank you, fourth graders. You can be seated. I'm sure all of you know what an incredible PTO we have and incredible parent support. This year, particularly the number of times we found treats in our mailboxes, food in the staff lounge, gifts on the rainiest of Mondays. I cannot be more grateful to the PTO for all of their support and help. Today, I would like to recognize three of our board members who are here with us today. Mrs. Amy DiPiazza, come on up. We have a Paton t-shirt for you. Mrs. Rachel Sharifapour, thank you so much. They were here at, I think, 6:30 this morning setting up. Thank you, Rachel. Not doing this so gracefully, but that's okay. Alyssa Roy, if you are, I know you're here somewhere, you come to the front. Thank you again. They planned and purchased and kept me on my toes when I needed it to keep the momentum going for the planning of the celebration, and we're really truly grateful. Thank you. It is time to not jive, but time to do some music signing. Signing to a beautiful song. Please stand. Face that way, my friends. We're gonna move and groove.
There seems to be no other song more appropriate this year than What a Wonderful World, especially following Dr. Lizotte's comments about how you are the driver of your own future. So as we sign to What a Wonderful World in this very bizarre year, this is your reminder for family, friends, and students that when you look at the bright side of things, things will go better for you. There will always be crummy stuff, and there will always be great stuff. Please enjoy our signing to Louis Armstrong's What a Wonderful World.
Trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue. What a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying,
just beautiful. Thank you, everyone. Our final speaker today is Miss Holly Riscosi. Holly just graduated a week ago from Shrewsbury High School, and as I mentioned earlier, she also graduated from Paton some years ago. Holly is off to the University of Notre Dame in the fall. She is, round of applause, wow. Woohoo! She has been super involved, not only in her high school career, but throughout the course of her life. Talk about service. She's dedicated many hours to service, and she's as humble as they come. So please join me in inviting Holly to share a few closing thoughts with us today.
My name is Holly, and I just graduated from the high school. And before that, I went to Oak, Sherwood, and as she said, Paton. So I'm so happy to talk to all of you on your fourth grade celebration day. And I can remember being here 8 years ago. Right off the bat, I'm thinking of some of my favorite memories from here. Playing four square at recess, our chorus concerts as a class, dressing up for some fun projects, field days, and reading during the book blizzard. Maybe some of you guys have the same memories too. Before me, my sister went to Paton, and after me, my younger brother. Some of you may have siblings that have or will come to this school, which makes it amazing how this Paton community continues to grow. This school is filled with so many amazing people, and it teaches important values that will help you as you continue to grow up. Even though you are celebrating the end of your time at Paton, remember that you are always a part of this special community. Visiting teachers and talking about memories from here will help you cherish the time you had. This celebration marks the end of your wonderful time at Paton and also the beginning of your next experience. I can remember when I sat in your position. At first, I felt a little bit sad, and that's okay. Like I said, this place is pretty awesome. I loved the teachers I had, friends I met, and activities I was a part of. I was still excited to be heading to a new school, but it felt a little weird to be saying goodbye to somewhere I loved. Paton is such an awesome place. The friends you made here will stick with you for a long time. You will always be a part of this community, but you will soon be saying goodbye to your time as a student here. Yet at the same time, heading to Sherwood in middle school next year is so exciting. You are going to get to meet tons of new people from the other elementary schools, as well as getting to have new teachers and try new things. It's okay to feel a little sad about leaving Paton, yet excited to be heading somewhere new. As you wrap up your time at Paton, I think there are a few important things to keep in mind for the new adventures ahead. First of all, as I have said, middle school is a new place, so the perfect opportunity to try new things. Joining band, chorus, a club, a sport, or anything like that can be a great idea. I really encourage you to try new things and find the people and activities you love to be around. These can develop into passions that you really love. Or maybe you try something and find out that it's not for you, and that's okay. Trying new things will allow you to discover what you love the most. With this can come some courage. You have to be brave to be willing to try something new. Be brave and be bold in thinking outside of the box, meeting new people, and trying new things. Next, always remember to try your best. I'm sure you've heard this a lot, but keeping with the theme of middle school being a new opportunity, think about how you can get to some really good habits. Always doing your homework, listening to directions, and working hard will allow you to find success in the classroom. Working hard can also be found in your passions, so giving 100% can also get you far in your sports, clubs, musicals, and more. Now I know you're heading into summer, so you can definitely allow yourself some time to relax. But when it comes time to start school in the fall, I hope you can meet the new year as motivated, ready-to-go students. As the summer goes on, maybe you'll even get a bit excited to experience school again at a new place. Finally, the most important thing that I hope you have gathered at Paton that you will use throughout your years in middle school as well as in life is kindness. When someone goes out of their way to treat you in a positive way, that gets remembered. You want to surround yourself with good people, so it's also important to be one of those good people other people want to be around. This can come in different forms. Being a good listener, showing support for your friends, and especially being inclusive. Inviting someone to sit at your lunch table or to hang out with your group can go a long way. Kindness is always remembered, so remember to always be kind. I wish you all the best of luck throughout this fun summer and for your next chapter of middle school. Thank you, Dr. Lazotte, for inviting me to speak today, and congratulations to all of you on your special fourth grade celebration day.
Thank you, Holly. Your words of wisdom were listened to by many and will be remembered. Now we have a little surprise for our fourth grade students. Stay seated. Here comes the rest of the school to say woohoo and congratulations. Here they come. And here's some music. Stay seated, fourth grade. Thanks to Mrs. Lafayette and Mrs. Smith and everyone for helping out. All these wonderful teachers, let's clap for everybody. Here we go, woohoo!
Shoots up through the stony ground, there's no room. No space to rent in this town, you're out of luck. And the reason that you had to care, the traffic is stuck. Anywhere you thought you found fair.
Thank you, everyone. Thanks for cheering us on, Paton School. Well, this officially concludes our celebration. We invite families, if you'd like to stay for a few minutes and take a photo here or perhaps in front of the building, our students are going to stay seated and families will come find you. Okay? Does that make sense or the other way around? Okay, students stay, families come on over, and thank you again. Have a wonderful rest of your day.